Welcome back to A to Z Dentistry. In this video, we'll discuss about anachoretic pulpitis and internal resorption. What is anachoresis? It is a phenomenon by which blood-borne bacteria, dyes, pigments, metallic substances, foreign proteins and other materials are attracted to the site of inflammation. Here, the bacteria that is circulating in the bloodstream tend to settle out or accumulate at the site of pulpal inflammation. This pulpal inflammation could be due to some chemical or a mechanical injury, which could either be a transient injury or a chronic low-grade inflammation. One of the probable causes of this phenomenon is increased capillary permeability in the area of the inflammation. The diagnosis of this condition is often complicated because of the absence of robust clinical or radiographic findings, because no pathological changes may be appreciated in the heart tissues both clinically and radiographically. And anachoretic pulpitis is a rare condition compared with the number of cases occurring as a result of dental caries. Next is internal resorption. It was first reported by Bell in 1830. It is also called as pink tooth of mummery because of the presence of pink discoloration, which is seen through the crown of the tooth, and is named after the anatomist James Howard Mummery. It is an idiopathic, slow or fast progressive resorptive process occurring in the dentine of the pulp chamber or the root canals. The exact etiology of this condition is unknown, but this could be due to history of trauma, orthodontic or periodontal therapies, low-grade inflammation. And herpes zoster inflammation is also considered as one of the causes for internal resorption. Usually, the dentine is lined internally from the pulpal surface by an odontoblastic layer and a predentine. So these two layers together form a barrier and prevent its resorption. Whereas loss or alteration of this layer will be followed by an invasion of the pulp by multinuclear giant cells or odontoclasts. And these odontoclasts causes resorption of the dentine from within. There are two types of internal resorption, inflammatory and replacement or metaplastic resorption. In inflammatory type, the resorbed dentine is replaced by inflamed granulation tissue. If radicular portion is affected, it will be usually asymptomatic, whereas if coronal portion is affected, the crown will display a pink discoloration, which is seen mostly at the cervical aspect of the tooth. Mostly maxillary anteriors are affected by this condition. And sometimes the resorption is so extensive, resulting in perforation of the crown or the root. In radiograph, if coronal pulp is affected, you will be able to see an area of destruction which appear as a uniform, well-circumscribed, symmetric radiolucent enlargement of the pulp chamber. But if radicular portion is affected, the original outline of the root canal will be lost, and a clearly well-defined symmetrical radiolucency which balloons out of the root canal can be appreciated. Next is replacement or metaplastic variety, and this is usually due to a mild low-grade inflammation like an irreversible chronic inflammation of the pulp or a weak injury. Here the resorbed dentine is replaced by bone or a cementum-like material. And these metaplastic tissues are entitled as reparative cementum or osteodentine-like material. In radiograph, it appears as an enlargement of the canal that is filled with a material that is less radiodense than the surrounding bone. And this will cause a partial obliteration of the root canal. Since these lesions are asymptomatic, the diagnosis is difficult. If coronal portion is affected, then a pink discoloration can be seen through the crown, and the vitality test may show a positive or a negative response, because coronal to the site of resorption, there will be necrotic pulp through which there will be constant entry of microorganisms to the site. Whereas apical to the area of resorption, there will be presence of vital pulp tissue, and because of that, the vitality test may show a positive response. So the diagnosis is made from the radiograph, in which a symmetric radiolucency of the pulp chamber or the root canal is appreciated. The management of internal resorption is complete removal of the pulp tissue followed by calcium hydroxide dressing, because it is a potent inhibitor of inflammation. And the obturation should be done with a plasticized gutta percha method. But if perforation of the root is present, then such defect should be filled with a mineral trioxide aggregate or a MTA. And this should be followed by obturation with a plasticized gutta percha method. And the prognosis is usually good if it is treated before the perforation occurs. In case of large perforation, you have to go for extraction of the tooth. Note that the pink tooth and pink disease are two different entities. Pink tooth is internal resorption, whereas pink disease is also called as acrodynia or Swift disease, and it is caused due to mercury poisoning. In next video, we'll discuss about cracked tooth syndrome and barodontalgia. Thank you.